In this video, we're going to cover one thing, HighlanderLink, UCR's website dedicated to getting involved on campus. There are many things HighlanderLink can do, but this video is going to focus on student organizations and the features you might want to take advantage of. This is HighlanderLink. To get there, you go to highlanderlink.ucr.edu. There is a public view that you don't need to log into, so people not associated with UCR can look up your organization and see very basic information. When you post things like events or news articles, you can choose if you want them to be viewable by the public. For the sake of this video, we're going to assume that you're logged in. This video is also assuming that you have administrative privileges in your organization. If you try to do some of these steps and you realize that you don't have access, contact Student Life at 951-827-7344, or you can contact your advisor directly to help update your group's administrators. Your past administrators can also give you access, if they're still on campus and available. Now, when you log into HighlanderLink, this is your homepage. It shows you events that are happening and news articles that groups have posted. As an individual, take the time to upload a photo and adjust your privacy and messaging preferences. You can also encourage your members to enable text messaging if you'd like to be able to send them text messages through HighlanderLink. If you have any pending invites to student organizations, you'll also see them here on your homepage. For right now, you're most likely concerned with maintaining and updating your organization's page. After you log in, you'll see a section that says My Memberships. Again, this is only visible after logging in. This section will show you every group that you're listed as being a member or officer in. If the group that you're representing right now isn't listed, that means you're not listed on their roster. Or, if you're a member of many organizations, you might need to click See All My Memberships. Again, you should contact either the prior admin to invite you to the group or contact Student Life. For now, we'll assume that you are listed and you can click on the group that you'd like to take a look at. This is your organization's homepage. As an example, we're showing you the page for Student Life. On this main page, you'll see all your basic info. The description is important and should be used as a way of telling people what your organization is about and why they should join. Having a profile picture is also very important. If you don't have a picture, potential members may not even look at your profile, as it looks like no one is maintaining it. And on the far left, you'll see a button that says Contact. This is helpful for when you're looking to communicate with other organizations. If you click on this, you'll send a message to the page's primary contact. The primary contact for each group has full administrative access by default, FYI. We'll discuss how to assign and change that later. Right now, we're looking at the Explore view, which is basically meant for looking at clubs and what they're up to. But if you're an officer, we're now going to show off how to use this page. You can click the Manage Organization button to get into the Manage view. Now, this page looks pretty bare bones, but there's a tab in the upper left. HighlanderLink has been known to not work so great with Internet Explorer, so if you don't see this drop-down menu, maybe try a different browser. So if you click on this, you'll see all your options show up. We'll go through them and show you why you might want to use them. Home is self-explanatory. It takes you right back to this page. The next tab is your roster, which is a very important tab and one that we expect to be fully accurate. Here, you'll see everyone currently listed as a member. Notice at the top, you'll see your primary contact listed. If you wanted to give this privilege to someone else that's already on your roster, you can easily just click the Change button. You'll also see tabs that say Current, Pending, and Prospective. Pending members are those that you've invited but have yet to accept, and prospective members are those that have found your organization and requested to be added to the roster. Let's start with the basics, inviting new members. Click on the button in the upper right that says Invite People, and then you'll enter a list of UCR email addresses. This is very important, and then you can invite them in one batch. They'll receive an email asking them to confirm this membership. Until they do that, they'll be in the Pending tab. If you see people on the Pending tab for a long time, you can check their names and click the button Resend Invitation to send them another reminder to accept. If your members say they haven't gotten an email or it's not working right, you can try emailing to the second version of their email. Everyone has a short version and a long version of their name. You can try the other email address and see if that works. Once you've added everyone, now you might want to give them officer titles or change titles. Next to anyone's name, you'll see an Edit Positions button. You can easily add and take away positions. One student can hold many positions at once. An important position to consider here is called Reserver. There is a Reserver 1 and a Reserver 2 title that can be chosen. These are the two individuals that have access to reserving rooms and accessing insurance for large events. Since you can hold multiple positions, it's likely that your reservers will also be president, vice president, etc. Once you change reservers, it can take up to 72 hours to refresh in the room reservation site, so be patient. We have a separate video specifically on event planning and room reservations that goes into that in more depth. On the roster page, you'll also see an option that says Manage Positions. Here you can change the access of any pre-existing position or create brand new positions. Maybe, for example, you only want your secretary to access events, but not the roster. You can change that. You can click any title and change the access to either all access or limited, and then choose what aspects they can control. The last button under roster is for messaging. Here you can send your message to people within the organization. Click on the Create Relay button to start this process. You fill in who you want the message to go to based on their positions or specific names. Then you click the Generate button. This will give you a long email address that you can copy and paste into your email provider. When you send an email to this address, it goes to everyone that you selected when you created the relay. You'll create a new relay for each email you send, since that address is only good for one use. If your members have turned on text messaging, you can send texts through this system as well. The About page is where you can keep all the info about your group that should be transitioned from year to year. Some of this info includes if you have a national headquarters, where you have your bank account, and other pertinent information. You can also edit your profile picture here. Events is going to be the other important tab that we really want you to take a look at. If you click on this, and then click on Create Event, you'll be given a blank form to fill out with your event's description. You want to make sure to attach an image so that when your event is submitted, it will appear on the homepage list of events. You can try your flyer for the event, but sometimes it may crop or distort your image. So feel free to use an image of your organization or a generic image of the type of activity you're doing. If you don't add an image, it won't be added to the main page, and you'll be depending on people to find your organization and look up your calendar of events, and you'll likely lose out on some potential. Some unique features here include the ability to generate a QR code that you can put on your flyers and handouts that leads directly to this event on HighlanderLink. You also have the ability to create RSVPs, so you can track who's attending or limit who's attending if you have a capacity concern. We encourage you to post all of your events on HighlanderLink, as more and more students will go to this list to find out what's happening on campus. If a student looks up HighlanderLink on their smartphone, it will also give them access to this list, so feel free to utilize this feature when you're tabling or discussing your group around campus. The news function is similar to posting a status on Facebook or maybe a tweet on Twitter. It can be brief and concise, or longer like a blog article. You can choose who sees this update, either the general public, only UCR students, or only your organization members. This feature is ideal for plugging opportunities in your org, upcoming events and meetings, or shout-outs about your organization and what they've accomplished recently. It shows up on the main page of HighlanderLink as well. Photo gallery is exactly what it sounds like. You can upload photos of your members, events, etc. You want a few pictures here because they'll show up on your home page, so it makes your page look a little more interesting. The Documents tab is where you keep important files, such as your constitution. You can choose the access levels of these documents, so you can decide if you want the files to be public, restricted to just your members, or only to specific officers. The Forms tab is where you can create interactive forms which function as a way to collect data. For example, if you want everyone to give feedback about a logo design, you could create a form and then they would fill out the form, similar to popular survey websites, and then you could view all the data together in a handy Excel or PDF format. To fill out a form, the individual must be logged into HighlanderLink, and it will connect to their account. So forms are not ideal for anything requiring anonymity. There's also a way to do elections inside of HighlanderLink. Everyone on your roster can vote, and you can use this either for individuals, voting on amendments to the Constitution, or even voting on which kind of pizza you want at the next meeting. There is a finance button, but right now it doesn't do anything, so don't worry about it. Lastly, the service hours button is a way to track how many hours your members are putting into various service projects. If your organization is interested in using this, try out what the site can do, and your org advisor can help you figure out different ways to input events and hours. It's a complex tool, but incredibly useful. That should give you a pretty solid start to understanding HighlanderLink. Again, there is much more to it, so if you're interested in other features, stop by the Student Life Office at 229 Hub and ask about what else it can do. If you've been watching this video as part of the re-registration process, click here to continue on to the next video. If you've been watching this just to learn how to use HighlanderLink, hopefully this was helpful, and thanks for watching.